Well, I'm back, and as promised, today is going to be about our feeder markets. What happened to those feeder markets over the summer? That was where I left you, and that's where I want to kind of tell the story that will impact our market as we move into fourth quarter. First, let's take a look at the trends that are impacting any feeder market, whether in Chicago, New York, Portland, anywhere that those of you that might be looking at the Florida market are coming from. And it's a statistic that really blew me away. So as of second quarter, $8 trillion in homeowner equity. That was the most recent kind of survey of the market. Well, what does $8 trillion in homeowner equity mean? Well, it means that if you look at it from 5 years ago, it's double what it was. Now, that's a really, really important piece of information. If you look at over the last 12 months even deeper, 750,000 homeowners across our feeder markets have seen positive equity in their home. That means that they move from a negative equity situation to finally seeing that their home values being in the positive territory. So, why is that important? Because 5 years ago, that was one of the things holding back people buying in Florida, that they weren't sure whether they could sell for more than they bought their home for. So let's talk about one feeder market in particular. I was talking to Robin Shakely, and Robin is vice president of Sipsey Klein. They're a great firm in Cincinnati. And I asked her, well, how was the summer? And she said, well, we've had a really good summer, but it's been held back by one thing. And that one thing is the lack of inventory, that in that market, people can't find the home that they want to buy, so they're not selling. And that's really pretty much as true across most of the feeder markets as it was in Cincinnati. So what does all that tell us about our market? Well, the great news is that you don't have to worry about inventory in Cincinnati or Chicago or New York to shop Florida. You have to worry about the inventory here. And I think that is really our silver lining, that our three counties really is ahead of the national curve on creating those future homes. Now, if you were to look at MLS inventory, which we do as professionals to say, what's the months of supply? Well, in the resale inventory, it is still very much a constrained market, which is why that mantra of it's a good time to list is very much true. However, what the choice is, and that's thanks to our new construction, is really the homes you won't see in MLS. That might be the three units that represent the other 20 you have to choose from. And so very much our feeder markets will see choice. In fact, some of that might be the challenge of spending a little more time shopping this season than simply focusing on the one or two things to buy. And so I do believe that we will have an exciting fourth quarter because we will be showing fabulous inventory to buy. So let's end with maybe the elephant in the room. How did the storm impact our market? Many of you might be wondering that. And I will tell you that the storms are always impactful, and we've watched on the news what that could mean. But the reality is, for our market, it has not impacted the desire to buy in Florida. So in conclusion, what does third quarter tell us? It tells us that we'll have the same consistent and healthy trends to drive fourth quarter that we really have relied on all year. Good choice in inventory, driven by new construction, and a very happy feeder market feeling comfortable looking at the Florida market for their next home.